Hello. How many people? Oh, we have five people already. That's good. That's good.
Hello.
Hello.
Good evening. Hello. Good evening.
Hello. Good evening. Thank you. Thank you very
Hello.
Much.
Good evening.
Hello. Good evening. We're going to start with the class. We have a lot of things to do today. Give me a moment. Okay, we have only four people. Carmen was here, right? Okay, let's wait for other people. We're going to start at 8:02. Vamos a comenzar a las 8:02. Vamos a esperar a los demás. Démosles un minutito para escribirles en el WhatsApp. Well, we're going to start with the people that we have right now. We have five people, right? We have Ricardo, Emerson, Sandra, Concepcion, and Alexis. So let's start. Today, give me a moment here. Today we're going to have the class when we're going to try to combine, right, present with present continuous, okay? Present and present continuous. So we're going to do a lot of things. We're going to start with the conversation. Bueno, tendríamos que comenzar con la conversación, pero tenemos muy poquitos. Let's start with another activity, okay? No worries. Today is video conferencia número 13. Present continuous with WH questions, right? What can you tell me about present continuous? Concepción, tell me the two uses that we have with present continuous. What are the two uses? What are the two uses that we have with present continuous?
Good evening.
Good evening.
Oh. La sodita,
I don't remember, teacher.
You don't remember? Why? ¿Por qué no? ¿Por qué no?
I am sorry. Okay.
Let's see. Sandra Gladys, what are the uses of the present continuous?
¿Dónde o cuándo, teacher? Where?
What are the uses? What are the uses? ¿Cuáles son los usos del presente continuo? ¿Cuándo lo voy a utilizar?
Cuando estoy haciendo la acción, action in the moment.
Okay, very good. When I'm doing the action at the time of speaking, or?
Or eventos futuros, future.
Or future plans. Very good, Sandra. Excellent job. With future plans. Very good. Now, Emerson, give me one example of present continuous for activities that are happening now.
Right now.
Okay, that's the time phrase. Give me one sentence as an example.
I am eating right now.
Excellent. I am eating right now. Very good. Emerson, choose another classmate, please.
Angie,
hello, Angie.
Good evening, everyone, teacher.
Good evening.
I am working right now.
I am working right now. Very good, Angie. Choose another person, Angie.
Mi amiga Azalia. No la veo.
Okay, Azalea is here. No, Azalea is not here yet.
No está, verdad. Okay, ¿y a Sandrita?
No, ya participó.
Ya participó en Sandrita. Es que me acabo de conectar. Hasta María Concepción, que es la que veo acá.
Okay, very good. María Concepción, good evening. Give me one example of activities that are happening now.
I am studying English.
I am studying English. Very good. Studying. Repeat.
Studying.
I am studying English. Very good, María Concepción. Now, tell me examples of present progressive in the future. In the future. María Concepción, choose another classmate. Escoja al otro, alguien más, por favor. Choose another classmate.
Noté la sensación de tensión Alexis. En el brazo.
What?
Y en la mano.
Alexis.
Alexis, ok. Alexis, ahora, tell me an example of an activity.
Ok. The future, ¿verdad? I am working next week.
I am working next week. Very good. Very good. Choose another person, Alexis.
Permítame, teacher, que no veo aquí a los compañeros. Celia.
Celia. Okay. Celia, give me an example.
Celia o Celia.
Celia, está bien.
Okay.
I am delivering checks next weekend.
Very good, Celia. I am delivering checks next weekend. Very nice. So we remember the structure of present progressive. Excellent job. Now we're going to continue here with the conversation. Yesterday, we were practicing a conversation, right? Do you remember the people you were working with? ¿Se recuerdan con quién estaban trabajando?
Ricardo, creo.
Yes.
Yes, teacher.
Okay.
Yes, teacher.
Very good. So, first of all, I am going to call the attendance. Primero pasamos la asistencia y luego nos vamos a practicar súper rápido. Okay? Give me one moment. Okay, I have here Ana Gabriela Córdoba de Samayoa. Ana Gabriela, Ángela de Jesús Santa María Juárez.
Presente.
Azalea Melanie Guardado Portillo. Carmen Lizeth Hernández Escobar.
Present.
Thank you. Celia Jasmine Castro de Chévez.
Present.
Daniel Amílcar Sandoval Avilés. Emerson Javier Rivera Rojas.
Present.
José Alfonso Palma Mejía. Juan Josué Hernández Hernández.
Present.
Leida Susana Soto Cuadra.
Present.
Luis Armando Ventura Campos. María Concepción Cerón Jovel.
Present.
Pedrina Iliana Gómez Ortega.
Present, teacher.
Ricardo Alexis Fuentes Rodríguez.
Hello, present. Present.
Ricardo Gabriel Barenga Ventura.
I'm here.
Roxana Yanira. Sandra Gladys Méndez de Barahona.
Presente.
Jennifer Abigail López Escobar. Okay, very well then. We're going to practice right now. We're going to create the rooms. We have okay. Now, who was your partner, Alexis? Who was with you?
Pedrina.
Pedrina, Pedrina and Alexis, very good. And Celia, who was with you?
Azalea.
Okay, Azalea and Celia, very good. Leida, who was working with you?
Emerson.
Leida and Emerson, very nice. Ricardo Gabriel, who was working with you?
Sandra.
Sandra and Ricardo, very nice. Carmen, who was working with you?
Angie and Jennifer
Abigail. Angie and Jennifer Abigail, okay. Jennifer is not here, but let's see. Maria Concepcion, who was working with you?
Luis.
Luis, okay. Now, you are going to work, Maria Concepcion, with Josue. He is going to help you to practice, okay? Si, si viene Luis, agregamos a Luis, okay?
Okay?
Very well then. I am going to open the breakout rooms right now. You are going to work in pairs. The conversation at 8:20, we come back here and we role play the conversation, okay? A las 8:20 regresamos y ustedes van a exponer su o van a hacer el diálogo que han creado. Is that clear? Yes?
Yes,
yes, yes. Okay, yes. Let's start. Let's start right now. Select your groups. Select your groups. Very good, very good.
Había silenciado mi micrófono. Oh, no se le escucha.
Any questions?
Entrecortado.
Sí.
Ah, tiene mala señal.
Sí, sí, tiene mala señal.
Sí. Sí. Es que voy manejando.
Ah.
Ah, sí, pote, okay.
No, pero nosotros ya habíamos avanzado con la conversation.
Ah, ok. Ya la tiene. Yeah, perfecto, yeah. Perfecto. Entonces, practice right now, Sandra. Practice the pronunciation and tell me if you have any questions, ok? Ya sabe cuál es el que va a trabajar usted. ¿Sí?
Yes.
Ok, very good. Si tiene alguna pregunta, solamente me llama aquí en el Eso, ok. Si les surge alguna pregunta, ya regreso.
Ok.
Thank you.
Bye.
¿Me escucha entonces? ¿Se fue o se quedó?
No, no, aquí estoy, sí le escucho.
Ah, vaya, lo que le iba a decir en la...
What are you going to do this vacation? Entonces pongamos esa, sería la primera, ¿va?
Sí.
Sería, sería what...
What are you going to do?
Okay. Sí, es que nos confundimos, teacher. Nosotros hicimos un, una como una descripción de lo que íbamos a hacer, pero ahorita ya sabemos que vamos a hacer un mundial o de
preguntas. Vamos a platicar entre los dos.
Ok. What are you doing? Y van a usar progresivo. Y usted está usando simple future ahí. Sería, sí. What are you doing next week?
Caballo.
Ok, very well. Repeat, continue, continue. Yo los estoy escuchando.
Bye. Espérenme que lo vamos a ordenar, teacher. Sí, todo. Patas arriba lo tenemos, porque no me confundí ahí.
La oración vaya. What are you? Going to this vacation.
Para...
Yes. What are you going to do this vacation?
What are you doing? What are you doing next vacation?
Next vacation. Ah, usar esta. Next. Ah,
no
next.
Diga going to porque no, es, no estamos usando ese futuro sí. Todavía.
Sería next, ¿verdad?
What are you doing next vacation?
Next vacation. Ah, next. Ok, ok. Va. Hoy sí. Ay, Dios santo. Vaya, ahora, ahora Alexis, hagamos una como que yo le pregunto y usted me contesta.
Exacto. Espéreme, 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 que yo me estoy más perdido que las cabritas de Heidi.
No, no le creo.
Yo sí.
Ok, but what is your question, Alexis? ¿Cuál es su pregunta?
No, o sea, ¿cómo, cómo organizarlo?
No, ya lo que hizo estaba mal, entonces haga algo nuevo, así no se equivoca.
Haga una, o sea, le vamos a dar vuelto a eso, Alexia, lo que tenemos, ya no.
Ok, ok. Escríbanme en el chat y ahí lo voy a contestar mejor, porque así es mentira, no lo entiendo.
Vaya, Alexia, ahorita le voy a escribir lo que tengo.
Sí, mejor así siento más, más fácil así.
Va. Ok. I don't see anything in the chat. No veo nada en el chat.
Me estoy esperando.
Vio, Alex.
Going, no, creo que en going creo que falta la G. Y creo que
ay, sí, 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 es que me equivoqué, no la puse. Sí, 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 no, no, es que no estaba viendo el teclado. Porque sí.
What are you
pero arréglala pues, Alexi.
What are you doing next vacation? Okay, very good.
Sí, agregué ahí, arregle la, la, lo que está mal escrito.
Pero no va a utilizar going to do, Pedrina. No me utiliza going to. Porque ah, no estamos utilizando going to. No.
Ah, sí,
solo
sí.
Sería, solo next. Sería go, entonces.
Go.
Es que es progresivo. No estamos utilizando going to. Going to es otro tiempo verbal.
Ok. O sea, solo en next to, ¿verdad?
Next. What are you doing next vacation?
Ah, next. Sí, sí, next vacation, ok.
Por favor, anótelo, Alexis. What are you doing next vacation?
Next vacation. Pero...
What?
What are you doing next vacation?
What are you doing?
What are you doing next vacation? Esa es una pregunta bien... fundamental. para comenzar la conversación.
Aquí.
What are you doing next vacation? What are you doing next vacation? What are you doing? Do not doing. Alexis, estamos utilizando progresivo. Recordémonos. Usted me acaba de dar un ejemplo bien bonito ahorita en la entrada de la clase. What are you doing next vacation? Very good. I am going to the beach. I am playing tennis in the park. I am eating a lot of seafood. Okay, different answers that you can have. Okay, sigan trabajando. I will go to another group. See you in a moment.
I am doing my activity. In my case, I am doing
Any questions?
Good evening, teacher.
Good evening. Did you finish?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. Can I listen to your conversation? Tell me one question.
Hello, Salia. What are some activities you are doing next week?
Hi, Celia. For the last week of the month, I will be finishing a Monday 29th.
I am finishing. You are using, ahorita me acabo de utilizar, futuro perfecto. No quiero que me utilice futuro perfecto. Estamos utilizando present progressive.
I am finishing.
I am finishing. Recuérdese la estructura que le di ayer. Subject plus verb to be plus verb with ing plus complement. Yo me estoy ocupando will be. Y will be no lo hemos estudiado todavía.
I am finishing day Monday 29th, deposit of banks and daily routes.
Roots.
Wednesday 31st. I am making deposited from banks, controls, and quadratures of the month of March.
Quadraturas. Okay, pero cuadraturas.
Del mes.
Pero eso está traducido directamente. Cuadraturas.
Okay. Cuadraturas.
Pero las cuadraturas se utilizan en geometría o se utiliza en astronomía también. Okay. What do? You check the finances.
Check
finances at the end of the month. Okay. Check finances.
Finances of the month of March. Mm-hmm. And I have to finish everything to on a quiet holiday.
On a quiet holiday. Quiet? ¿Cómo deletreamos esa palabra? get holiday? ¿Qué dijo? ¿Cómo traduce eso? ¿Cómo lo escribe? Antes de holiday.
Get.
¿Cómo lo deletrea?
Q. U. U. E.
I.
E.
I-E-T, right?
I-E-T.
Okay. Quiet. Quiet. Repeat, quiet. That's kid, it's quiet. Repeat.
Quiet.
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 Very good.
Holidays.
Quiet holiday, okay? Let's go with the others. Let's go, let's go, let's go. Okay, so let's start. Let's start. Who wants to begin? No, let me see here. We're gonna put a beautiful number here. 1, 2, 3. How many people? We have 12 people. Okay, we're going to start here. Tell me a number from 1 to 12. Tell me a number from 1 to 12. Celia. Un número del 1 al 12. Tell me a number from 1 to 12.
9.
No. Okay. Carmen, 1 to 12.
11.
11. No. Leida.
Few.
Leida, a number from 1 to 12.
Five.
No. Angie?
One.
No. Josué?
Two, teacher.
No. Concepción?
Four.
No. Azalia?
Yo seré la premiada. Six.
No. Luis?
Three.
Nope. Emerson?
Seven.
No. Alexis?
One.
No, ya lo redijeron, ya lo dijeron.
Escuché, two.
¿Ah?
Two.
Two, ya lo dijo José.
11.
Ya lo dijo Carmen. ¿Cuál le falta?
8.
Very good. 8. Okay, very good. 8. So you start with my friend Pedrina. We're going to listen to your conversation.
Okay. Ese ya había truco ahí.
No, pues lo escribí antes, ¿ves? Eight.
Vaya, pues, eight.
Okay,
this 8
is very
ugly.
Okay,
sí. Ay, Alexi.
Hola.
Entonces me pregunto usted y le contesto yo, ¿o qué?
Vaya, está bien, el problema. Lo único que no les hemos hecho muy larga.
Pero yo lo hice algo, le agregué otro poquito. Pregúnteme.
Ah, vaya, pues le pregunto, pues. Hi, Pedrina. What are you doing next vacation?
I will going stay back.
Yes. What are you doing at cinema?
No, I going at cinema. I will going a mountains. I family.
Yes. Very good.
Y le pregunto yo ahora.
Como usted guste.
I won't going out O sea, ¿dónde vas a ir tú? Le quise decir.
Where are you going? Where are you going?
I am going to beach, cinema, gym, working también.
Fantastic.
Okay, very good. Give them an applause. Very nice, very nice. You're welcome. Thank you so much. Now, Pedrina, choose another person from this group.
El número, me está preguntando. ¿Va?
No,
número.
Choose another person. Ahorita sí, dígale.
Ah, vaya, ok. Celia.
Celia Jasmin Castro de Chévez. Uh-huh. Who is your partner, Celia? Oh, it's a Celia. Ok, Celia and a Celia. Okay, go ahead.
¿Lista, Celia?
Cheese, cheese.
Cheese. Okay. Hello, yes. Estelia. What are some activities you are doing next week?
Hi, Celia. For the last week of the month, I am finishing day Monday, 29th, deposit of bank and daily route. And Wednesday, 31st, I am Cheques Finance Bank control of the month of March, and I hope to finish everything to go on a quiet holiday. You're going to do next week, Celia?
I am waiting the report the sales on Monday. I'm delivering checks on Thursday. I am studying English the Friday at 8 p.m. And you?
Go eat. Yes, I am studying English the Friday.
Okay, you finish?
Finish.
Very good. Get them an applause. Very good. Get them an applause. Very nice. Just check here. I am putting some of the phrases that I can catch while you speak. I am going to the beach. I am not going to the cinema. I am going to the mountains. Where are you going? Where are you going? I am going to the cinema. I'm writing the sales report. Sales report. Change it, Celia. And then pronunciation. How do you pronounce the fifth day of the week? How do you pronounce the fifth day of the week? After Thursday, we have Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, and days of the week?
Friday.
Friday. Very good, Azalia. Friday, not Friday. Friday. Okay? Very good. Now, let's continue. Choose another person, Azalia.
Ricardo.
Ricardo Gabriel and Sandra Gladys.
Okay. Sandra, hello.
Hello. Hello, how are you?
I'm tired. What are you doing?
I'm learning English right now.
That's great. I'm beginning study English too the next month.
That's perfect. How do you do in weekend?
I'm cleaning my house. And you?
I'm going to Termo del Rio next Saturday.
Nice. See you later.
See you. Bye.
Bye. Okay, very good. Very good. Very good conversation. They combined both. You listen to that? They combine present for activities at the moment of speaking and present progressive for the future. Okay, combinaron ambas. Muy bien hecho. Excellent job. Sandrita, choose another person.
Mm.
Carmen.
Carmen. Carmen and Angie, right?
Yeah.
Carmen and Angie. Okay, let's listen to you.
Okay. Hi, Angie. Glad to see you. Tell me, what are you doing tomorrow morning in your office?
Hello, Carmen. How are you? I am checking my email and sending pushing orders. And you?
Well, I am attending meetings with my team on Monday morning. What about you, Jennifer? But Jennifer is not here right now. What are you doing next Monday morning, Angie?
I am attending meeting with my boss and my co-worker from 8 a.m. and 2 at 10 a.m. And you, what are you doing for the afternoon?
Oh, wow, you're very busy. In my case, I am doing my activity summary for next week because I am starting my vacation period from next Tuesday.
It is this song good and enjoy your vacation time.
Thank you.
Very good. Very good. Give them an applause. That's an excellent conversation. Thank you so much. Carmen and Angie. Very good. And remember, the word summary, le van a utilizar bastante. Summary, resumen, okay? Resumen, hay que recordarnos de esa palabra, bien importante, summary.
Teacher, in this case, I can see my activity summary.
Yeah, I can see my...
I am collect all my activities for giving another person to give the tracking, for example.
You can say, I am summarizing my activities. I am going to write it here. I am summarizing my activities for the week, for the tracking, or for example, right?
Okay.
I am summarizing
my activities for the tracking. Okay.
For the tracking. You. Very good. Choose another person, Angie.
Emerson.
Emerson Javier. Emerson. And Leida, very good.
Thanks, Angie.
Good evening.
That's Ahorita. Hi, Emerson. What are you doing?
Hi, Leida. I am reviewing the reports and email for the employees meeting. And you?
I am a student at the library. What are you doing next Sunday?
I am going for a walk in the park. What are you going to do next Sunday?
I am going to the movies with my friends. You want to go with you?
It would be a pleasure to go with you. Finish the church.
Okay, get them an applause. Very good, very good. It will be a pleasure to go with you. That's a very polite answer. Okay, remember in English, we can say cinema. Usually in Canada, you would say cinema, right? And movies is the same. Let's go to the movies. Let's go to the cinema. The same, okay? And then it will be a pleasure to go with you. Será un placer acompañarte. Okay? It will be a pleasure to go with you. Now, very good. Leida, choose the last person, I think, the last group. Who's missing? Ta, ta, ta. ¿Todos pasaron ya? No, Concepción is missing.
Luis.
Luis and Concepción. Okay, Luis and Concepción.
Hey. Hello, Mary. How are you?
Hello, Liv. I'm fine, thank you. And you?
I'm fine. How are you able to do this week on the work?
Well, there are many things I am doing this week. For example, I see meeting on Monday and Friday. Take care of human resource needs and what about?
That's okay. I will make a report every day. On Wednesday, it is preventing maintenance of the machine.
Who is chairman of the company?
Carlos is.
Okay, that's it?
Yes.
Okay, very good. Give them an applause. Very good. We just need to work a little bit more. Luis Armando, open your mouth when you speak, okay? Abra la boca cuando escribe, cuando habla. Abra la boca cuando habla. Eso que les han dicho de que no hay que abrir la boca para hablar inglés y que se habla mejor, no. Eso es para la gente que nació allá y que ya conoce el idioma desde pequeño, okay? Nosotros tenemos que pronunciar bien para que nos entienda, okay? So open your mouth, okay? Because you are like this, if you're like this, people won't understand what you're saying, okay? Si ustedes hablan así, no le van a entender, okay? So, let's continue. Now, everyone has participated. Daniela Milcar, Ana Gabriela is sick, right? So she's not going to be with us, right? So tomorrow you will make your presentation, okay? Now, we continue here with one practice, but no, let me see here. We're going to do this later. Esta la vamos a hacer después, no se preocupen. I want to explain this to you, okay? We have this with the simple present versus present continuous, okay? Simple present against present continuous. Now, there are two things that we need to be very careful with when we're working with simple present and present continuous. What are those things, right? When we're talking about that, there are certain characteristics that we need to pay attention to. What are those? Look at this. It says here, we use simple present, right? For general information, right? For general information or for routine activity. Okay, for general information or for routine activities. Let me put here. That's when we use simple present. Okay, routines, general information. When do we use present continuous? We are going to use present continuous for ongoing actions at the time of speaking or activities in the future. Okay, that's what we're going to do. Yes, thank you, Salia. Page 32, exactly. So, what happens here? Here, we are going to base ourselves on context, okay? Vamos a trabajar con base en contexto, okay? Con base en el contexto. Ya podemos utilizar el simple present, ya podemos utilizar el present continuous. Ahora, cuando se nos presenta una situación en general, vamos a tratar de combinarlos, okay? We're going to try to combine them both, right? For example, let's read the four sentences that we have in simple present. Number one, Sandra Gladys, can you please read the sentence in simple present?
What? Can you?
Can you read the sentences in simple present, number one?
I check my email every morning.
Very good. Please read number two, Pedrina. Number two.
He write report about meeting.
Okay. He writes reports
report
about meeting.
About meeting.
Okay, very good. Number three, please, Alexis.
She
audits.
Addis. She addis
inventories.
Inventories.
She addis inventory. Okay. She audits inventories.
Inventory.
Okay. Number four, Angie.
Yes, teacher. They arrange meetings.
They arrange meetings. Good. Now let's look at this. All of these are activities that happen every day. These are routines. Okay. Now we go with present continuous. We got number one, Josue.
I am planning a video conference.
Okay, I am planning a video conference. Very good. Number two, Carmen.
They are getting the documents ready.
They're getting the documents ready. Very good. Number three, Emerson.
She is editing the information.
She's editing the information. Very good. And Leida, number four. Leida Susana.
The secretary is making a phone call.
Okay, very good. The secretary is making a phone call. Very good. Now, remember general information, routine and activities, ongoing actions or future actions. Okay. Ya se los pueden. Eso no tiene que afligirlos porque ya se los pueden. Right? Now, we are going to start working with the exercises here. Right? But first, we're going to do an exercise with present progressive only. Present progressive only. This exercise is on your book as well. I don't remember which page I took it from. I think it's page 42. 32, right? We have these sentences. We have six sentences that we are going to complete with the verbs that we have there in parentheses, right? Thomas is printing the contract. So in this exercise right now, we're using present progressive only. Okay? Present progressive only. Para recordarnos cuál es el present progressive, right? So, let's go ahead and do this individually. Vamos a hacer esto individualmente. Y luego vamos a hacer otro ejercicio where we can combine them. Okay? Okay, let's do it. ¿Ya encontraron el ejercicio en el libro?
Yes, teacher.
Yes, very well. Teacher. Very well, very well. Tell me when you finish.
I finished, teacher.
Very good, very good.
Finish.
Listo.
Very nice. Thank you so much. Everyone, did you finish? Now, can I check everyone? ¿Ya terminamos todos?
Yes, teacher.
Yes, yes.
Una cuestión. ¿Cómo, cómo voy a identificar en una oración cuando tengo que pronunciarla toda de una sola vez la palabra? Porque hay, me he fijado que hay palabras que se dicen juntas o se dicen de una sola vez.
Exacto.
Y siento yo que ahí es donde tal vez me confundo, porque como estamos aprendiendo, entonces leemos así pausadamente.
And that is entonces, normal.
Ajá, entonces quisiera saber cómo puedo, cómo irme acostumbrando y aprenderlas a leer así, tal vez juntas, no todas, no se la ven, ¿verdad? Tal vez dos, o que se oiga un poquito más entendible, por decirlo así.
Con la práctica, Alexis, es la única forma. Tiene que practicar más para ir identificando las palabras que se van pronunciando juntas. Usualmente en inglés, usualmente todas las palabras se pronuncian unidas, ¿verdad? Usualmente. Esto quiere decir que usted tiene que, la única forma es de practicar, no hay como una fórmula, digamos así, mágica, que yo me voy a aprender esto y ya se me quedó así, no. O una regla. Hay reglas de pronunciación, sí, ¿verdad? Pero solamente con practicarlas. ¿Ok?
Ok.
Only with practice. You have to practice a lot. Practice with songs, ¿ok? Practice with songs, practice with tongue twisters, vea música, vea videos, practique las líricas. That's the only way, con la práctica. No hay solamente esta palabra y esta van juntas, sino que la mayoría de palabras, like every single word in English has to be together. So they sound natural.
Ajá, o sea, mi consulta era porque need you. Se pronuncia todo junto. No se escucha need y después tú. No te va de una sola vez. Por eso era la duda. Sí. Pero sí, ahí tengo que practicar, ¿no?
Sí, con la práctica. Sí. No hay una lista de palabras que usted diga solamente estas. No. Es la pronunciación, así tiene que ser. Ok. Right now, I am going to check the exercise. Let's see, this is a very easy exercise that we have with present progressive, right? Number two, what do you have in number two, Leila? Cheryl.
Cheryl is meeting.
Read the sentence. Cheryl is meeting.
With the boss right now.
Excellent job. Number three, Pedrina.
Pedrina. Ahorita. He is taking care of everything.
He's taking care of everything. Very good. He's taking care of everything. Okay. He's taking care of everything. Very nice. Now let me see here, Concepción, number one, number four.
I am paying attention to the instructions.
Okay, I am paying attention. I am paying attention, very well, to the instructions. Number five, there please, Josué.
She is preparing the briefing.
The briefing, okay? She's preparing the briefing. Un briefing es como lo más chiquito de todo. Si van a tener una conferencia y la conferencia dura 3-4 horas, the briefing tiene que durar 5 minutos, okay? No more than that. Very good. The briefing is like a summary. And number six, please help me out, Alexis.
Aquí, en este momento, they are sending their product today in warehouse.
Okay, they are sending the product to the warehouse.
Yes.
Repeat.
They are sending they product to their warehouse.
Okay, listen and repeat. They are sending the product to the warehouse.
They are sending the product to the warehouse.
Very good. Your answers, everyone's, they are correct. You have good answers. Very good. Now I am going to show you something else right now. That is,
teacher.
Yes.
Sorry. What is the difference between boss and chief? Because sometimes I listen. I spoke with my chief, or I get in a meeting with my boss. I don't know what is the difference. When do you need to use boss or chief?
Boss is just a person. Anybody can be a boss, right? For example, is in my work, I have like three different bosses, right? So it's the person that is there. But chief is more like to say about a status, right? Like the owner of the company, right? Chief is pretty much like a leader. In Spanish will be like el dueño de la compañía, el líder, el que está a la cabeza de todo, the chief, right? But the boss, for example, the chief can have different bosses, right? El jefe puede tener, el chief puede tener diferentes jefes o supervisores. Okay. So chief is like this in the status, and then we have a boss. Okay?
Thank you.
You're welcome, Carmen. Now, we are going to work here before we work with the exercises. I want you to do some exercises, but I want you to tell you something about present continuous. Okay. In present continuous, we have some verbs that they cannot be with ing. Okay. Ya vimos algunos verbos que pueden ir con ing. Okay. But there are some verbs that they cannot be with ing. Okay. Usually, only the verbs that have action, for example, drinking, writing, speaking, they can be with ing. But there are some verbs like they express emotions or that they express feelings, right? Those are the verbs that we cannot use with ing. Those are called stated verbs, okay? Esos son verbos que se llaman stated. No se pueden utilizar con ing, okay? We have to pay attention with that. Now, let me show you which are they. Can you look at my computer right now?
Yes, teacher.
Okay. So, we know the use of present continuous, right? And it says some verbs are almost never used in the present continuous. Let's listen to that. Some verbs are almost never used. Okay. Almost never used in the present continuous. Casi nunca se utiliza. Okay. The most common are. Esta es una lista de verbos que no se va a utilizar en present continuous. Okay. What is the list of verbs? We have agree, be, believe, belong, care, forget, hate, hear, know, like, love, mean, mind, notice, on, remember, seem, supposed, understand, want, and wish. These verbs you cannot use in with continuous or with the progressive. For example, you cannot, it's okay if you say, I love you. That's correct. I love you. But You cannot say, I'm loving you. That is incorrect, okay? For example, right? You cannot say, I am believing you. You are going to say, I believe you, okay? ¿Qué quiere decir? Que estos verbos no los podemos usar. Estos verbos no los vamos a utilizar con el present continuous, okay? ¿Van a haber excepciones? Sí, right? Pero son excepciones that they are almost never used. Almost never used, okay? So you cannot say, I am understanding you. I am wanting you. I am wishing you. No, that is not correct. Now, I want you to please take a screenshot of these verbs because they are going to help us, right? Yes, with the exercise that we are going to make. ¿Se entienden esos verbos?
Yes, teacher.
Okay. Cosas que tenemos que recordar. Things that we need to remember, right? If the verb does not represent an action, you cannot use it with present continuous, okay? Usualmente los verbos de acción son los que utilizamos con ing, okay? With present progressive, okay? Por ejemplo, no podemos hacer con una acción de suppose. ¿Qué acción podrían ustedes hacer con suppose? ¿O qué mímica podrían hacer con suppose? Or understand. Or belong. ¿Qué mímica podrían hacer con su cuerpo? Belong, believe, love. Right? They are not action verbs. These are stated verbs. ¿Se entiende esta parte?
Yes, teacher.
Yes?
Teacher.
Yes.
Esta clase de verbos no van a sufrir ningún cambio con el ing. ¿Verdad?
Exacto. Lo va a utilizar con simple present.
Correcto. Pero sí pueden ser parte de alguna oración que los demás verbos sí vayan con el ing.
Yes, yes, of course.
Sí, ¿verdad? Yes, o sea, yes. van a estar en su estado puro, por decirlo así.
Exactly.
Okay, okay, okay.
Okay, can I continue? ¿Me avisan si puedo continuar?
Yes, teacher.
Thank you, Angie. ¿Los demás?
Yes, teacher.
Yes, teacher.
Yes, teacher.
Yes, teacher.
Okay. Now, let me share with you the first exercise that we are going to do. Okay, the first exercise. And in this exercise, we are going to use right now the present continuous or the present simple, okay? That is the exercise about. Necesito que tratemos de ver la posibilidad de utilizar present continuous or present simple, okay? Present continuous or present simple. That's the exercise. Let's take a look at the exercise. It says here, Carmen, can you please read the instruction for me?
Yes, of course. Two women are talking at a party. Match the question on left with the answer on the right.
Okay, we are matching the questions right now. The questions, the numbers with the letters. Okay, that's what we're going to do. If I have, for example, what do you do? What could be an answer here? What do you do? Yes, I am. Is that an answer?
No.
No,
no.
Right. It's not an answer.
Psychologo. I am a student.
Psychology? It says, what do you do? Psychology.
I am a student.
I am a student. Very good. I am a student. So we connect that one. We put them together right here. I am a student. Okay, very good. Let's do the others and let's do them individually. Lo vamos a hacer de forma individual, ¿ok? Para tratar de entender lo más posible. Y si nos equivocamos, está bien. There's no problem. Please take a screenshot so you can complete your activity. Okay, can I move from here? Okay, now, while you work, I will call the attendance. Okay, yo paso la asistencia mientras ustedes terminan su ejercicio. De forma individual, okay? Now, let's see here. Ana Gabriela is not here. Ángela de Jesús.
Presente.
Azalea Melanie.
Present.
Carmen Lizeth.
Present.
Celia Jasmine. Daniel Amiter. Emerson Javier.
Present.
Thank you. José Alfonso present. Palma. Thank you. Juan Josué Hernández.
Present.
Leida Azucena.
Present.
Luis Armando Ventura.
Present, teacher.
María Concepción Cerón.
Present.
Pedrina Iliana.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Ricardo Alexis Fuentes.
Present, teacher.
Ricardo Gabriel Barenga Ventura.
I'm here.
Roxana Yanira. Sandra Gladys. Jennifer present, Abidail. Teacher. Thank you. Okay, very well. So, did you finish your exercise?
No,
not yet. Okay, let's not do yet. It. Let's do it. Tell me if you have questions.
I finished, teacher.
Very good.
Todos. Lo que puede ser. Bueno, hay que comprar. ¿Cuáles compraste?
Questions? Did everyone finish? We're going to check right now. Not yet.
Yes, flat teacher in a flat.
A flat is an apartment.
Yes.
An apartment. A flat.
El nombre de una persona.
No, a flat is an apartment. Flat significa apartamento.
Ah, un
flat
un
is apartment. An apartment. Yes, flat is an apartment. Tell me when you finish, everyone. Did you finish? Emerson, Azalea, Celia, Pedrina? Not yet? Did you finish?
Finished.
Very good, thank you. Azalea, Emerson, did you finish?
Finished, teacher.
Very finished, good. Teacher.
Very good, very good.
Finished, teacher.
Excellent. Now, let me show you here again the computer. And you are going to tell me the answers, right? Okay, no, not that one yet. Okay, we have this one right here. Okay, we have the first one. What do you do? You told me I am a student. Number two, Carmen, what are you studying?
Psychology.
Psychology, very good. Psychology. What's that you're drinking, Angela? What's that you're drinking?
Lemonade.
Lemonade, okay.
Lemonade.
Lemonade, very good. Are you enjoying the party, Gabriel? Gabriel? No? Alexis? Are you enjoying the party?
Yes, okay.
Yes, okay?
Yes.
Okay, let's put that one. Where do you come from, Pedrina? Where do you come from?
Where did you come from? Yo tengo esta in a flat with on a student. Pero creo
in a
que...
flat with other students. Okay, I don't know. Where are you living at the moment? Where are you living at the moment? Josué?
I am from Vietnam.
Okay, where are you living at the moment? I am from Vietnam. Okay. How are you getting home, Leida?
I am walking.
I am walking. Okay, very good. Do you want to dance, Carmen?
Yes, okay.
Yes, okay. Okay, so we have two yes, okay. Now, let's check the answers. Right, let's check the answers right now. Let's take a look at the meaning. Ahorita estamos viendo meaning. Nosotros ya sabemos cómo crear las respuestas. Ahora estamos dando respuestas así simples, sencillas, lo más prácticas. What do you do? I am a student. That's correct. What do you do? I am a student. What are you studying? Psychology. What are you studying? Psychology. What's that you're drinking? Lemonade. Are you enjoying the party?
Yes, I am.
Yes, I am. Very good. Yes, I am. We're going to move this one right here. Are you enjoying the party? Yes, I am.
Yeah.
Very good, Sandra and Carmen. Where do you come from?
I am from Vietnam.
Very good. I am from Vietnam. Where do you come from? I am from El Salvador. I am from El Salvador. Very good. Where are you living at the moment?
In a flat with other.
Exactly. In a flat with other students. In a flat with other students. How are you getting home? I'm walking. Very good. I'm walking. Repeat, Sandrita. Walking.
I,
Walking.
Walking.
I'm very walking.
Good. Do you want to dance? Yes. Okay.
Yes. Okay.
Yes, okay. Very good. These are the answers. ¿Entendemos las preguntas y las respuestas que estamos dando, chicos? ¿Tienen alguna pregunta de pronunciación, definición, palabras, algo? Please let me know. Miren el ejercicio y díganme si tienen alguna pregunta del ejercicio. Pronunciación, vocabulario. ¿No hay preguntas?
No,
okay. Now let's go ahead and continue. We're going to do another exercise. Remember, we are practicing present progressive and simple present together. Okay? When putting it together, estamos poniendo juntos. Now, we have this paragraph. Okay. In this paragraph, you are going to do right now the verbs. You are going to decide if the verbs are in simple present or the present continuous. Okay? Ustedes van a decidir, van a leer el párrafo y van a decidir, este es in simple present or in present continuous. Okay? But you are doing that in pairs. Okay? Este es un poquito más difícil, lo vamos a hacer en parejas. Okay? We are doing that in pairs. Please take a screenshot of the exercise.
Yes, teacher.
Okay. ¿Tomaron el screenshot?
Yes.
Yes, okay. Teacher.
Very well. Now that you have taken the screenshot, right, I am going to put you in pairs. So you're going to work with your classmates. No van a trabajar con las mismas personas que estaban antes. No se preocupen. Un momento. There we are. Okay, let's go right now, please. Let's practice simple present or present continuous. Select your group. Select your group, please. Jennifer, Leida, select your group. Pedrina.
Según el conteo tenemos 7 minutos.
Okay. Do you have any questions?
Solo digo que había que leer, hablando. ¿Verdad? Leer y decidir si es en presente continuo o
en presente simple.
O en presente simple, ajá.
Exacto. Y lo van a ir llenando. Ok, very good.
Bueno, bueno.
I see you in a moment.
Ok. You that the police.
Es una pregunta.
Ajá.
Hi, teacher.
Hi.
Help me, teacher. Help me, teacher. Help me.
Why?
Estamos tratando, descifrando. Hello. O sea, como aquí dice lo del verbo be, ¿verdad?
Be is a verb. So we have to decide if we are using present simple or present continuous.
Exactly.
In a question, if you are
using a present simple, you have to use the auxiliary because it's a question.
It's a question, exactly. If you are using present simple.
If I use it. Mm-hmm. If we are using present continuous, is where are, what mm-hmm. are that the police
want? But right now, it's not asking you, it's just telling you to use the verb be.
Be.
Use the verb be. How would you conjugate the verb be in that sentence?
Is that the police?
Is that the police? Yeah. Is that the police? That's simple.
Sorry.
Is that okay. Is that Angie? Yes.
Okay. I am.
Uh-huh. Is that Angie? Yes, that's Angie. Right. Okay. Very good. I'm going to send you right now.
Okay.
Ricardo Gabriel ya le va a venir a acompañar.
Okay. Is that the police?
Thank you.
Okay, the question. Also, I
estamos en la primera. Estamos en la primera de hello.
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 Hello. Hello.
Le voy a bajar un punto por cada vez que me diga hello, ya
ve. Hey teacher, me cuesta decirlo.
Ahí sí estoy con be. Puedo cambiarlo por do.
¿Por qué lo va a cambiar por do?
No se puede.
Y es ser, ¿verdad?
Tendría que ser igual.
No le encuentro, es que no le encuentro sentido a la oración.
No, es que esta no, esta creo que no se puede cambiar porque está uno de los verbos que no se puede convertir.
Pero necesito un complemento. Exacto. A la oración.
Correcto.
¿Cómo se lo pondría usted? ¿Erexes?
Lo pondría normal.
¿Cómo es normal?
Vi.
Did.
Vi.
Be. No, porque pero be, ¿cuáles son, no. ¿Cuáles son las combinaciones del verbo be?
Sería is,
are, is, y am.
Ajá.
Entonces, de esas tres, ¿cuáles utilizarían?
Is
that the police?
Is.
Ajá, is that,
escuchan la policía. Is that the police?
Is that the police? Ah, o sea, está el policía. Así, hello.
Esa es la policía. Hello, is that the police?
Hello.
Hello. Is that the police?
Mm-hmm. Hello.
Hello. Sí, si me dice hello, le bajo un punto.
¿Y si lo digo bien? ¿Y si lo digo bien?
Ya lo va a decir bien.
Hello.
Hello.
Hello, is that the police?
The police. Thank you, teacher.
You're welcome. See you in a moment.
El otro sí su cambio.
How right now?
Creo que así es. They have a party. They have or having.
Yeah.
El segundo creo wow. que, bueno, pues, este creo que es have.
No simple.
They have a party. ¿Qué ve? They have a party and they playing.
Playing es continuo.
King can win. They are playing music.
Music. Mm-hmm.
The living, okay. Ever.
When you're using ringing, coming, playing, ¿qué le hace falta? What is missing? In present progressive, what is the structure of present progressive?
Instruction.
Mm-hmm. What is the order?
Okay, este.
Ajá. Very good. I am ringing. Very good. I will see you here working right now. Okay. I will be back in a moment. I will go to another group, okay?
Okay, teacher.
Thank you.
Okay.
I creo que iría. They are have until the
festival. Yes. They are playing.
They are playing music. Very lovely, sería, ¿verdad?
Very lovely, uh-huh, to men. Who is
men?
Who is living?
Acá solo sería living, ¿verdad?
Uh-huh.
Living, they're having.
They're how?
Or have or having.
Este, no recuerdo si este es en los verbos que ella notó, no aparece el have como
en los verbos.
Ok, en lo que notó. Donde habla sobre el uso del presente continuo. Donde está every, be live, be low, or
esta. Start,
forget. It. Ajá, ajá. Mira.
Son verbos que no se utiliza el presente continuo.
Hey, Corin.
He isn't taken. Taking any notice, teacher.
Yes.
And teacher.
Mm-hmm.
Tenemos esa duda.
¿Cuál duda?
¿Dónde está be? Es porque tiene que ser el verbo ser.
Yeah.
Hello, is that...
Hello.
Hello. Hello. Mm-hmm. Hello, is that the police?
Yes, very good. That's okay. Correct. Mm. Hello, is that the police? Repeat.
Hello, is that the police?
Excellent job, very good.
I am reading to complain about the
mm-hmm.
noise which coming from the flat above me, the having a party and they playing music very lovely. The men were living there having a party every weekend. And every weekend I am asking him to turn the music down, but he isn't taking isn't taking any notice. And they they are not leaving.
They are not leaving until 2 a.m. Mm-hmm.
They are not.
They are not leaving until leaving. They don't leave until 2 or 3 a.m. What is are not leaving or they don't leave?
And they are.
¿Por qué?
aren't.
¿Por qué? Is aren't living or don't live? Is simple living. Present or present continuous?
Doesn't.
No, escúcheme. Living. Is simple present or present continuous?
Present.
Simple present, no. Ok. Si simple present, ¿cuáles son los usos del simple present? Para acciones que se hacen repetidamente, rutinas, hábitos que tienen las personas. ¿Usted cree que ese es un hábito? And date, don't leave until 2-3 in the morning. ¿Cree usted que es un hábito el que tienen ellos cuando en esas fiestas?
No.
¿No es un hábito?
No, porque es de vez en cuando.
De vez en cuando, ok.
O sea.
Dice every weekend. Every weekend. ¿Qué quiere decir? En every weekend. Dije a party every weekend.
Y algunas veces.
La próxima.
Tenemos que ver todas las palabras. Los adverbs of frequency, las palabras de right now, todo para ir entendiendo el párrafo.
Okay? La conversación.
Sí. Let's go with the others. I will see you in a moment, okay? Voy con los demás. I see you in a moment.
Okay.
Hello, how are you doing? Pedrina. Pedrina, how are you doing? Okay. Okay, we just came back from an exercise. Did you finish the exercise? Did you finish the exercise? So?
No.
Not yet?
Yep.
Yep, okay.
No, teacher.
Okay. Not yet, okay.
Yes, teacher.
Yes, okay. Let's try to complete this exercise together, okay? We are a team, somos un equipo, vamos a hacerlo todos juntos, okay? Vamos a hacer el ejercicio juntos. Let's do it and let's pay attention, porque en este ejercicio está un poco complicado, I know, but we can do it, okay? We can do it. Now, we have the first one, right? Hello, what do you have in the first one, Alexis?
Is.
Is, very good. Hello, is that the police? Hello, is that the police? Very good.
Hello.
Hello. Hello. Give me one more. Is that the police? What do you have next, Carmen?
I am ringing.
I am ringing to complain. Okay.
About the noise.
Okay. I am ringing to complain about the noise. Which, Angie? Angie, next verb. Angie.
Excuse me, teacher. No podía activar eso. Hello, aquí estoy. And which is coming from the flat?
Which is coming from the flat above me. It's coming from the flat above me. Okay, very good. Okay. They, let's continue here, Emerson. They
are have.
Are have. Okay. Are have. Is this the correct form of present continuous, Emerson? Or have?
Are having.
Are having. Very good. Are having. Ya le voy a explicar ese verbo. Are having a party and they, Sandra. Sandra, and they. No? Okay. Azalia, and they?
Ya, teacher. Ya, teacher.
Playing.
They playing.
Playing.
Okay. Is this the correct form of the present continuous, Sandra? They playing? Yeah. Only that?
Yes.
Are you sure?
Sure. A mi forma de ver, sure.
Okay. What is missing here, guys?
They are.
They are playing. Sandrita, they are playing music very loudly. The man who, what do you have in this one, Azalia? The man who?
Mango live. Living.
Dígamelo duro que no lo escucho. The man who?
Living.
Who living. Okay. Is this the correct form of present continuous?
No.
No. Porque conserva la forma natural.
Okay.
Why? Is the present continuous.
Okay, why not?
We'll leave. Because it's not right now, it's a routine because the man lives there forever and ever.
Every day. Very good. That's a routine. Excellent job. A eso quiero llegar. Very good. The man who lives there. Ese hombre vive ahí. Vamos a utilizar simple present porque es una rutina, es un hábito. Okay. The man who lives there. Okay. The man who lives there, Gabriel?
They have a party.
Okay, have a party every weekend. Okay.
Every weekend.
It's in simple present. Now tell me, Gabriel, we're saying the man who. The man is he, is that so your pronoun, he.
Yeah.
The man who lives there.
Only the man.
It's singular.
It's singular.
Okay. Now let's change this verb into singular.
What?
The man who lives there have a party. Have a party? Is that correct?
It's a singular person.
Okay. Yes. If it's singular, is he. How do we change the verb into third person singular? Gabriel?
Ruler to S.
Okay, the rule of S. How do we put this verb with the rule of S?
Plus, agregue la S, haves.
Haves?
Who
wants to have second. Gabriel?
Haves.
Has. The man who lives there has a party every weekend. Mírense, recuérdense de eso también. When we say every weekend, every weekend, this phrase, it tells me, oh, a routine. It's a routine. Okay? Very good. Now let's continue. And every weekend, Celia?
I am asking.
Every weekend, is it a routine or something that happens now? Can ¿Qué le dice la frase every weekend?
Routine.
Routine. ¿Y con
cada qué? Semana.
Ok, y qué, ok, sí, esa es la traducción, perfecto. ¿Cuál de los dos tiempos vamos a utilizar para routines?
Present simple.
Present simple.
Present simple. ¿Cuál es la respuesta?
I ask.
In every weekend, I ask. Very good.
Yes.
In every weekend, yep. I ask. And every weekend, I ask him to turn the music down. But he, what can we put here, Concepción?
He does take.
He does? Okay, it's negative. Remember, he does?
Doesn't.
He doesn't take. Very well, Concepción. He doesn't take any notice. No le importa. He doesn't take any notice. Right? And they, what do you have here, Leida? And they?
They doesn't.
They doesn't? Can I use does with they? ¿Puedo utilizar das con day?
No.
Uh-huh. So what is going to be the answer? ¿Cuál es el correcto que voy a usar?
Acá.
Don't. They don't. Eso sí lo tenemos que tener así, chicos, ya en la mente. They don't leave until 2 or 3 in the morning. Okay. Now, let's continue here, Alexis. What do you have? I not complain very often. What's the answer? Often, remember, is a bit of frequency. Often, it's something, often, it's a habit, often. It's a habit.
Doesn't.
I doesn't complain. Can I use doesn't?
Okay.
Is this correct, Alexis? Yes. I doesn't complain?
Yes, usted está negando.
No, no está correcto. When am I going to use does, Alexis? ¿Cuándo voy a utilizar does? ¿Con qué subject pronouns I can use that? No solo porque estoy negando.
No, no, no. Hágalo un poquito, quiero ver el complemento de la oración. Eso puedo.
Eso no, no, eso no. Eso ya está bien. Usted está poniendo simple present. Quiero que se fije en esta forma verbal. Does I doesn't complain?
Do is.
Okay,
what's
the answer? What is the answer?
Espérame, teacher, espérame. Mm-hmm. Porque está hablando de I no complain. No, teacher, ya me enredé. Mm-hmm.
No, usted sí sabe, porque ya lo vimos. Listen to me again, Alexis. Can you use does with I? ¿Puedo utilizar does con I?
No, no.
Okay, no. What is the answer?
Do.
Okay, dígame la respuesta.
I am do complain.
Again?
I do complain.
Okay, and you told me it was negative. How can I make this negative? Usted me dijo que era negativo. ¿Cómo lo hago negativo? Wait a moment. What is the negative form of do? ¿Cuál es la forma negativa de do? No es doesn't.
No, espéreme, que me estoy acordando del otro, se me ha olvidado. Don't.
Ok, don't.
Don't,
very good. I don't complain very often. I don't complain very often. Very good. I don't complain very often. But tonight, the noise is awful. And, Josué?
It's keeping me awake.
It's keeping me awake. Very good. And it is keeping me awake. Me tiene despierto cuando el vecino se bulla. Okay, it is keeping me awake. Oh, good. You, what do you have next? Here, let's see. Daniela Milka. Oh, good. You?
Sending?
Sending, only sending, Amilcar? Is that the correct form of the present continuous? Oh, good, you sending, is that it? Así solamente, you sending. Daniela Amilcar? ¿Qué le hace falta ahí? What is missing?
You have sending?
You have.
No, you have.
¿Por qué have?
No have. You have.
¿Por qué has?
No.
¿Cuál es la estructura del present progressive, Amilcar? ¿Cuál es la estructura que vimos ayer? Ajá. Miren los ejemplos de sus compañeros, cómo lo han escrito. El present progressive.
Yo.
Amilcar. Who wants to help Amilcar? What is missing there?
Are.
You are. Alexis, no estamos viendo present perfect todavía para utilizar has and have combinado con otros verbos. You are. You are sending a police car round. Okay, next one here, Angie. Where do?
Ay, excuse me.
We're surrounded.
That's a ghost.
Where do I live?
Where do
where
I?
Do you live? Where do I live?
Live it.
Where do I live? Live.
Okay. Where do I live? Oh. 36 Innie Gardens, London, right? Now, look at this exercise. Very good job. You have done a very nice job with this, right? Now, we need to pay attention to phrases that will help us to understand if it's present progressive or if it is simple present, okay? Hay muchas frases que nos dicen prácticamente qué es lo que está pasando y qué tiempo verbal vamos a utilizar, ¿ok? ¿Qué tiempo verbal vamos a utilizar? Now, do we understand this exercise right now? ¿Tienen alguna pregunta? ¿Entendemos el ejercicio? ¿Tienen alguna pregunta? ¿Les quedó alguna duda? Por favor, hagan las preguntas ahora. ¿Están seguros que no tienen preguntas?
Yes, I have a question.
Go ahead, Gabriel.
Vaya, en el verbo que usted me dijo, have, has, es de los, hay cierto tipo de verbos que sufren toda la sufren una modificación completa y ese es uno de ellos, es así.
Este es un verbo irregular.
Okay.
This is an irregular verb. There are some verbs that in English they are called irregular. Irregular verbs are, for example, go, do, has.
Yes.
Esos son ejemplos de verbos irregulares. Y no siempre van a cumplir con las reglas que tienen todos los demás.
Ah, ok. Ok.
Exacto. Entonces, este, cuando estamos hablando del third person singular, in simple present, we're going to use have, they have, she has. Esa sería la estructura correcta.
Okay.
Okay, good question, Ricardo. Thank you so much. Gracias, Ricardo, por su pregunta. Another question, please. Díganme sus preguntas, chicos. Sin pena. Entre todos las vamos a responder.
Teacher.
Yes.
Tengo una duda con respecto a la última. No iba a agregar el I am live. Where do you I am live? O solo where do you I live?
Ok. Esa es una pregunta excelente. Es María Concepción. What happens here? And look what I have. What I have here is the auxiliary to. Okay. Y eso es lo que vamos a hacer, es como un tip, algo que nos vamos a recordar siempre. Si yo tengo una pregunta que ya lleva el auxiliar do or does, no vamos a mezclarlo con el verbo to be. Okay. No lo vamos a mezclar, porque si lo mezclamos, entonces se nos va a hacer un gran relajo. Por ejemplo, dijera la pregunta, where do I am living? Where do I am living? No se puede utilizar. Vamos a decir, where do I live? ¿Dónde vivo? ¿Dónde vivo? Where do I live? Right. Si usted quiere preguntar, where am I living? ¿Dónde estoy viviendo? Where am I living? Right? That's different. Right? Where am I living? I am living with my fathers. Right? Pero cada una tiene su contexto diferente. Okay? O uso el auxiliar do o does, o uso el verbo to be con present progressive, por ejemplo, past progressive, dependiendo del tiempo verbal que voy a usar. Por eso no le agregamos aquí el verbo to be arriba. El, ¿ok?
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Las dos de esas que ha puesto son correctas.
En este contexto, no. La única correcta es la que
la primera,
tenemos arriba.
La que está ahí.
Sí.
Ajá. Pero en otro podría usarse where I am living.
Where am I living? Exactly. Ajá. Where am I living?
Ok.
Y en la segunda sí lo puedo cambiar, teacher, a living.
Where am I living? Yes. Porque estamos usando present progressive. Eso sí.
If the question is right now, you can say, where I am living?
Yeah, where am I living right now?
Right now.
Uh-huh. ¿Y where do you live? Living, no lo
puedo. Where do you live? Cuando le preguntan, where do you live? Es que le están preguntando, ¿dónde vives? ¿Dónde usted vive? Como decía Carmen en su ejemplo anterior, toda la vida. ¿Dónde está viviendo? ¿Dónde vives?
No, perdón, where do I live in? Eso no lo puedo decir, I live in.
No,
where?
No, eso es incorrecto.
I...
Sí, where do I live in? No, that is incorrect. Okay, any other question? Preguntemos, por favor, vocabulario o algo que se haya quedado. No.
No.
Sí. Okay.
Teacher.
¿Qué es, Alexis?
Aquí dice, and every weekend. I ask. ¿Qué es ask?
For example, every day I ask you questions. Every day I ask you questions. Todos los días le hago preguntas. Ask significa preguntar.
Okay.
Ask.
No, no. Tal vez te refieres.
Ask. Pronunciation.
Ask. O ask, te pregunta.
¿Cómo?
Pensé que él se refería aquí del how, donde dice ask. Pero si le había entendido mal entonces yo lo que estaba aquí. Preguntando.
No, él se lo preguntó por el significado de ask.
Ask.
Uh-huh. I am asking for money right now.
Y donde dice there have, also has.
There has, exactly, because we're talking about the man. The man is he, and the sentence is in simple present. So we need to put the verse in simple present.
Okay,
very good. Now, we are going to stop here. We have 2 minutes. Any other questions? ¿Alguna otra pregunta?
Podríamos repasar esto tal vez.
No, y lo otro, dicha, no me queda claro aquí, a party every weekend, en every weekend, en ask, ¿por qué no uso ask you?
Porque estoy diciendo every weekend. Every weekend ya vimos los adverbios de frecuencia. ¿Se recuerdan que vimos los adverbios de frecuencia?
Sí.
Los adverbios de frecuencia nos ayudan a nosotros a decidir qué tan a menudo hacemos una actividad. Cuando decimos que hacemos una actividad es una rutina, un hábito. Y usamos simple present para describir rutinas o hábitos. Routines or habitual facts that we do every day.
Sandra, do you say every week or every weekend? Because every weekend is for Saturday and Sunday.
Mm-hmm.
And every week is from Monday to Friday. Friday.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Mm-hmm. Sí, pero en ambos casos es lo mismo. Siempre vamos a utilizar simple present. ¿Por qué? Porque estamos diciendo every weekend. Mm-hmm. Estamos usando every weekend.
Con rutinas no puedo usar ing.
No, you have to use simple present.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. You have to use simple present. Exactly. Any other questions?
No, teacher.
No? Okay. No.
Thank you, teacher.
You're welcome. Now we're going to do tomorrow another exercise.
Teacher.
Like this. Yes.
Today are 22. It's the 10 p.m.
Thank you. Thank you. I'm so sorry. Yo quiero poner otra
exercise. What? Another exercise.
I'm so sorry.
It's emotion.
Tomorrow. Thank you, Carmen. Okay, ligerito. Ángela de Jesús.
Presente, teacher.
Ana Gabriela.
Seguimos.
Paramos, seguimos.
Azalia Melody.
Present.
Carmen Lizeth.
Present, teacher.
Y así dormido.
Present.
Seguimos.
Daniela Milcar.
Present, teacher.
Emerson Javier.
Present, teacher.
José Alfonso Palma. Juan Josué Hernández.
Present, teacher.
Leida Susana Sorto.
Present.
Luis Armando. María Concepción.
Present.
Pedrina Iliana.
Present, teacher.
Ricardo Alexis. Alexis.
Present, teacher.
Ricardo Gabriel. Roxana Janina. Thank you. Sandra Gladys.
Present, teacher.
Jennifer Abidail. Okay, very well. So, have a beautiful night, and I'm just going to stay with one person. Gracias, Carmen. I'm so sorry. Ay, qué pena. Okay, now we're going to stay just with one person, I think, right? And the others, have a beautiful night. See you tomorrow.
Bye.
Bye-bye. Recuerden si quien se queda hoy, miércoles 17, Concepción.
Chau.
Bye-bye. Si no se queda Concepción, ¿se puede quedar alguien más? Okay. Hi, Concepción.
Hi, teacher.
How are you today?
So-so.
So-so. Tell me, Concepción, what's your question?
Oh. Pues, no personal, creo que lo voy a hablar en español porque no entiendo mucho el inglés.
Okay, dígame, no es problema.
Pues tengo quizás un pequeño problema con el estómago.
¿Con él?
Con él, para entender un poco el inglés. Porque a veces me quedo perdida cuando se está dando la clase. Uh-huh. Entonces me toca como, ¿qué le digo? Interpretar prácticamente lo que está diciendo porque me quedo así como, ¿qué le digo? Pues,
pero en este caso, ¿no entiende nada o entiende palabras?
No, sí entiendo palabras. Entonces, por eso es la manera de formar lo que usted está diciendo.
Exacto, es que así es, así es. Usted si los ve traduciendo todo, ahí déjelos. No se preocupe, ¿ok? Si usted está entendiendo, si de todo lo que yo digo en inglés, usted entiende un poquito, recuerde que estamos en el nivel 2. Apenas llevamos, ¿qué? 7 semanas en clases. Y no sé si usted tenía tiempo de no recibir clases de inglés y solamente lleva 3, ¿verdad? Entonces, por eso es que siente el cambio. Y la clase la estamos dando casi que toda en inglés. Hay pedacitos que damos en español para que se vayan acostumbrando. Entonces, cuando si no entienda nada, usted escríbeme el chat, ¿ok? Y yo lo voy a repetir en inglés y lo voy a repetir en español, para que usted vaya asociando el significado de las palabras, pero, como usted mismo lo dijo, no lo traduzca, interprételo. Ah, dijo exercise, dijo complete exercise. Ah, pues quiere que completemos un ejercicio, ¿ok? Entonces, así, sin ir traduciendo todo palabra por palabra, porque a veces eso, cuando nosotros estamos hablando español, la traducción directa al inglés suena horrible. Cuando lo estamos traduciendo, suena pero terrible. O cuando hacemos de inglés a español. Entonces, si usted interpreta, estamos por muy buen camino, Concepción. ¿Ok?
Yo siento que cuando me he metido en Google, me juega un poco chico. Porque a veces no me da lo que se supone que usted está hablando. Entonces, es como, ok.
Como... Como Google, acuérdense que Google es una máquina y le va a dar lo más general, lo más estándar. Entonces, y nosotros utilizamos, el inglés se basa bastante al contexto en el que usted lo va a utilizar. ¿Okay? Hay palabras que yo siempre les digo, no se casen con un solo significado en una palabra. Por ejemplo, ahí está la palabra get, que es esta, get, que tiene en el diccionario, tiene como 20 significados. Es una palabra y tiene significados distintos. Vimos un día un texto que estaba la misma palabra, esta palabra get, y en cada oración significaba una cosa distinta. Entonces, no hay problema. Si entendemos de las 20, entendemos 2 ahorita, uf, perfecto. Así vamos a ir practicando poco a poco. Ahora, yo le aconsejo que... vaya, como dice usted que le cuesta un poquito más el listening, vaya practicando también con, hay unos vínculos en la página, en el libro, ¿verdad? Usted se fija que hay unos vínculos, usted puede practicar con esos vínculos porque están relacionados con la clase. Al final, que están unos vínculos que tienen unos headsets, unos de estos. No sé si los ha visto. No. Te lo voy a mostrar. Creo que aquí tengo. Permítame.
Ah, sí.
¿Ya lo vio?
En la página 35 hay uno.
Sí, en casi cada dos páginas hay unos. Hay unos que a veces por algún motivo se cierran, no se pueden utilizar, pero usted puede utilizar esos y le van a ayudar para el listening. También les recomiendo que, por ejemplo, si usted ve televisión, YouTube o ve Netflix, siempre póngalo con subtítulos. Póngalo en inglés y con los subtítulos. Hay muchas personas que dicen, solo ponlo en inglés y así vas a entender. No, pon en inglés y subtítulos. A medida que usted va mejorando, usted le va a ir quitando los subtítulos para ir entendiendo mejor. ¿Ok? Al inicio, con subtítulos, no hay problema. ¿Okay? Y también practique con líricas, con canciones en inglés que le vayan ayudando, pero no canciones rápidas. No me voy a poner un rap o un hip hop ahí para practicar. ¿Ok? Una cancioncita súper tranquila. Usted primero la escucha, ¿okay? Y va viendo la lírica en la pantalla. Luego va escuchando y va tratando de imitar los sonidos que ellos hacen. Así usted asocia las palabras con la pronunciación. Y ya luego ya usted puede ir practicando. ¿Ok? Pero es un proceso. Se siente que es un proceso, ay, qué lento, ¿verdad? Pero es la mejor forma si no vamos aprendiendo a lo desordenado. Primero escuchamos, leemos, después escuchamos, leemos y pronunciamos. Okay. ¿Okay? Y de ahí vamos a pronunciar. Y si usted va a decir, a saber cómo pronuncié, me voy a grabar, yo me grabo. Y luego trato de escuchar lo que dije y lo que está diciendo en la canción. ¿Suena igual? ¿Suena totalmente distinto? ¿O ahí va sonando más o menos? Es que esa es la única forma. Esa es la única forma para ir aprendiendo pronunciación y que usted vaya diciendo, ah, yo escuché esta palabra en la canción. Ella dijo, listen. Ah, listen. Ok, escuchar. Si usted ya va asociando esa palabra con el significado. Lo que tienen las series en Netflix es que la mayoría hacen los gestos para hablar. Okay? Pay attention, listen to me, right? Para que la gente vaya entendiendo qué es lo que vamos trabajando. Okay? Okay, very good. Do you have any specific questions? ¿Tiene alguna pregunta específica?
Fíjese que con respecto al presente, lo que estamos viendo ahorita actual, ¿verdad? Tengo mis pequeñas dudas, pero ¿cuántos minutos son para nosotros?
¿Ah?
¿Cuántos minutos son? No, yo le pregunto porque
diez. Son 10.
Son las 10.
10 y 10. No, vaya, es que fíjense que está bien fácil. Con el presente simple y el presente continuo. El presente continuo lo vamos a usar. Cuando estamos hablando de cosas que pasan al momento que estamos hablando, ¿verdad? Vamos a usar presente continuo. Vamos a usar presente continuo cuando vamos a hablar de cosas, planes en el futuro, present continuous. ¿Cuáles son las frases que me van a ayudar a entender a mí present continuous? Right now, in this moment, at the present. Eso es, está hablando de cosas que están pasando ahorita. Voy a usar present continuous. Luego, simple present, lo usamos para hablar acerca de rutinas o hábitos o actividades que hacemos diariamente o a la semana. O sea, son actividades que se repiten, ¿verdad? Por ejemplo, I teach English every week. Okay? I am teaching English right now. ¿Se ve la diferencia?
Sí.
Si ella me pregunta, I teach English every week. Eso es simple present. I am teaching English right now. Ese sería present continuous. ¿Por qué? En una utilicé every week para decir que es una actividad que hago como rutina, como un hábito, ¿verdad? Y la otra es cuando utilicé right now, que significa ahora. Estoy dando clases ahora de inglés. ¿Ok? Entonces, esas serían como las diferencias más amplias del simple present y el present progressive.
Ok, yo por eso llevo una anotación de todas las clases.
Perfecto.
Cuaderno prácticamente, que anoto prácticamente todo lo que usted va diciendo. Porque al principio me tendía a confundir porque la teacher anterior, sobre lo de, usted nos estaba dando de, ¿cómo se llama? Del correo, nos dio al principio. Entonces yo vi muchas palabras nuevas con usted que yo me quedé con esto. Entonces, luego me tocó, me mandó a sala con Emerson.
Ajá.
Y al principio, entonces, y como nos empezamos a presentar y todo, y en mi grupo soy la única que está en el grupo este, en el que estaba anterior, pero estoy viendo cosas muy nuevas con ella y me dijo, ah, sí, es muy buena. Voy a aprender muchísimo porque ella me dio el primero.
Sí, pero no se preocupe, usted pregunte, si usted no entiende, usted pregunte, así como hacen todos los demás. No, usted no hay problema. Yo le voy a repetir hasta que entendamos. Por eso les digo, pregunten. Y si no, toca repetirlo hasta que ya entendamos qué es lo que vamos a hacer. Porque si no, nos vamos a ir después al siguiente módulo y no vamos a saber nada.
Sí, eso sí tiene mucho.
Sí, ok. ¿Tiene alguna otra pregunta?
No, es más que todo era lo que le comentaba, que mi confusión entre el present simple y el...
Le voy a mandar una horita. Permíteme. Déjeme ver, deme un minutito de su tiempo. Le voy a mandar una práctica para que empiece, ¿verdad? Oiga, los gallos ya están cantando.
Ya están diciendo que vamos a dormir.
Ya no, qué pena que hoy, yo pensé que estaba más temprano, fíjense. De verdad que sí.
Cuando lo iba a poner a hacer el otro ejercicio.
¿Qué le pasa? ¿Con qué número empieza su número de teléfono?
63.
Ok, ¿63 qué?
11, 84, 80.
Le voy a mandar acá unos links que usted puede utilizar, unos vínculos que usted puede utilizar para ir practicando la pronunciación. Son canciones tranquilas, ¿verdad? No son canciones de reggaetón ni nada de eso, no se preocupe. ¿Ok? Ahí están los cuatro para que vaya practicando, ¿verdad? Y vaya mejorando poco a poco. Cuando los termine esos, me avisa y le mando otros. ¿Ok? Okay, perfect. Okay, have a beautiful night, Concepción.
Thank you.
See you tomorrow.
Hasta mañana.
Hasta mañana. Feliz noche.